Okay, a very good morning, dear students. In the last class, we were discussing how to construct a triangle when its base, one base angle, and the difference of two other sides of a triangle given. If any one side has the base, its length is given, one base angle is given, and the difference of other two sides is given. How to construct the triangle? It was discussed in detail in the last class, and I am sure you must have understood. Now, today let us discuss the last construction as given in your class 9 NCERT syllabus. What is that? How to construct a triangle? Suppose you are given perimeter of a triangle. You know what is perimeter? Perimeter is the length of, the sum of three sides of a triangle. Suppose you are given the length of perimeter of a triangle and two base angles given. Any two base angles given and the perimeter of triangle is given. How to construct the triangle and how to justify it? Let us discuss today. See, let me explain you the steps with the help of an example. Suppose we want to look at the board. Suppose we want to construct this triangle ABC whose two base angles are angle B 45 degree, angle C 60 degree, and the perimeter AB plus BC plus AC equal to suppose 14 centimeter. Now how to construct the triangle? What is the process? The process is, you see children, first you take this perimeter, look at it. First what you will do? Take the perimeter, suppose name it XY or PQ, whatever, okay. Let this perimeter of triangle ABC, what is given, be taken by the line segment XY. That means this is 14 centimeter. Okay. Now, what is the next step? The next step is what you will do. You see, we will justify it later. See, whatever is the measure of the two base angles. Angle B is 45 degree. Angle C is how many degree? 60 degree. Now take half of angle B. Half of angle B. Draw half of angle B. That means angle B by 2 at the vertex X, you see. So whatever is the measure of angle B, draw half. You see, it is given 45 degree. That means you have to draw, suppose this is 90 degree. This is your 45 degree. You see, this is your, suppose 45 degree. Then you bisect this 45 degree. See, suppose this is the bisector. You see, this is 22 half. That means after taking XY equal to 14 centimeter, which is the perimeter of the triangle, at the vertex X, what you will do? Construct half of angle B. You see, why we will construct half of B? It will be justified later. Okay. First, let us understand the steps of construction. See. So at the vertex X, construct half of angle B. That is 22 half degree. You know how to construct. First you construct 90 degree, then bisect it, you will get 45, then you bisect again 45, so that you will get 22 half or half of angle B. Okay. Now, suppose, at the vertex Y, you see, at vertex Y, construct half of angle C. What is the measure of C given? It is given 30 degree, so half of C means 30, 60 by 2, 30 degree. So you draw here 30 degree. See, suppose this is my 60 degree and this is my 30 degree. Look at it. This is my 30 degree. See, so this is 30 degree. Now look at it. So we constructed half of angle B at the vertex X and half of angle C at the vertex Y. Now look at these two angle bisectors. You see, these two angle bisectors. That means this is how many degree? This is 45 degree. You can name it D, no problem. You can name it D. And this 60 degree, you see, this 60 degree, you can name it E, you see. This angle is 45 degree. After constructing 45, you bisect it, you will get 22 half. That means half of angle B is to be constructed at the vertex X. Similarly, half of angle C, you construct at the vertex Y. Suppose this is your half of C, this is 60 degree, this whole angle, that means angle XYE, angle XYE is 60 degree, now you draw the bisector. So you see, after drawing the two angle bisectors, what will happen? They will intersect at a point, you see. This is one angle bisector, this is another angle bisector. Suppose they intersect each other at the vertex or at the point A. suppose the two angle bisectors, they intersect at A. Okay, now what is the next step? Now the next step is, you draw the perpendicular bisector. You see, draw the perpendicular bisector of AX and draw the perpendicular bisector of AY. Suppose this is my perpendicular bisector. This is the perpendicular bisector of AX. And draw the perpendicular bisector of AYC. I am drawing the perpendicular bisector of AY. With the help of rounder you will do. I am using my hand. See. So after getting the point of intersection A, that means AX is the bisector of angle BXY. See, angle BXY, which is the bisector? AX. Angle XYE, which is the bisector? AY. Now the two bisectors, they intersected each other at a point. Suppose the point is A. Now after getting A, look at AX and look at AY. Draw the perpendicular bisector of AX and draw the perpendicular bisector of AY. Now, this perpendicular bisector of AX, it will intersect XY at a point, and the perpendicular bisector of AY, it will also intersect XY at a point, at a particular point or at a certain point. That means the two perpendicular bisectors of AX and AY, they will intersect XY at two distinct or two different points. Suppose the two distinct points, name it B and name it C. Okay, now we got the points B and C. So after getting the points B and C, you join AB and you join AC. Okay, now see, ABC is the required triangle, or ABC will be the required triangle. Okay, so this is the step. See, now we are going to the step 1. So these are the steps how to construct a triangle when its perimeter is given and any two base angles given. Now the point is, you can ask, sir, how will we justify that perimeter? Yes, of course we got the triangle ABC, but how to justify that perimeter of this triangle is equal to 14 cm? That means it is equal to the length of the line segment XY, because in the beginning we have taken XY equal to 14 cm, which is the perimeter of the triangle. Now we have to justify that perimeter of triangle ABC, that is AB plus BC plus AC, is equal to XY. We have to justify, we have to prove that AB plus BC plus AC equal to XY. Now how to justify? Let us see. And then we have to justify. See, after justifying that the perimeter of this triangle is equal to the length of the line segment XY, that is 14 cm. Again we have to establish that this angle is 45 degrees and this angle is how many degrees? 60 degrees. Because it is, we have constructed how many degrees here? We have constructed at the vertex X 22.5 degrees and 30 degrees. But what are the measure of the given angles? The measure of the given angles B and C are what? 60 and 45 and 60. That means we have to prove that this angle is 45 and this angle is 60. Angle B is 45 and angle C is 60. Okay? Let us see the justification. See. Now, look at the point B. Look at the point B. Where does B lie? See, B lies on this perpendicular bisector. And this is the perpendicular bisector of which line segment? AX. You see, B is a point lying on the perpendicular bisector of AX. That means the point B lies on perpendicular bisector of AX. And point C lies on this is the perpendicular bisector of AY. So C, point C lies on perpendicular bisector of AY, and point B lies on perpendicular bisector of AX. So you write down, so B lies on perpendicular bisector of AX. So what will happen? If point B lies on perpendicular bisector of AX, then what will happen? This point will be equidistant from A and X. We know it from previous constructions where I have already discussed, and also in the chapter circle. Okay. If a point lies on the perpendicular bisector, then it will be equidistant. If a point lies on the perpendicular bisector of a chord, it will be equidistant from the two endpoints of the chord. So as B lies on the perpendicular bisector of AX, so B must be equidistant from A and X. Therefore, B is equidistant from x and a, you see. So b is equidistant from x and a. Now if b is equidistant from x and a, then the length of bx will be equal to the length of ab. That means ab will be equal to bx. Therefore, ab equal to bx. Okay. Now similarly, see, point C, it lies on the perpendicular bisector of AY, so C will be equidistant from Y as well as A, okay. So similarly, C will be equidistant from Y and A, that means, similarly, AC will be equal to CY, CY equal to AC, you see. If B is equidistant from X and A, then AB equal to BX. If C is equidistant from A and Y, then AC will be equal to CY. Okay? Now, let us find the length of XY. See, therefore, you see, therefore, what will be the length of XY? Let us find out XY. What is our aim? Our aim is to show that XY equal to AB plus BC plus AC, which is the perimeter of the triangle that we have taken earlier in the beginning. Okay? So, now see XY, look at the figure, XY, this XY can be written as XB plus BC plus CY. So, XB, XY can be written as XB plus BC plus CY, okay. Now, XB equal to which one just we discussed now, XB will be equal to AB, so it is AB, in place of XB write down AB plus BC. Plus, CY is equal to AC, just we proved because C is equidistant from Y and A. So, in place of CY, it will be AC. So, you see, thus we proved that the length of line segment XY is equal to the perimeter of the triangle, what we had taken earlier. Okay. Now, let us prove that this angle is 45 degree and this angle is 60 degree. Because we have taken half of angle here and we have taken half of angle C at the vertex Y. Okay. So, how to prove that this angle is 45 and this angle is 60 degree? Let us see. Now, look at the triangle AXB. You see, in triangle AXB, look at. In triangle AXB, see, this angle is AXB. This is exterior and these two, angle BAX and angle BXA. See, this angle, this small angle. Angle BXA and angle BAX are two interior opposite angles and this is the exterior angle. And you know what is the relation between an exterior angle and two interior opposite? You know what is the relation between an exterior angle and its two interior opposite angles? An exterior angle is always equal to sum of the interior opposite angles. So, in triangle AXB, if this is exterior, angle ABC is exterior and these two are interior opposite, angle BAX plus angle BXA or AXB, whatever you say. Angle AXB. Okay, I hope you understood. Now next step, you see. But this angle and this angle, angle BAX and angle AXB, they will be equal. Why they will be equal? Because AB and BX, they are equal. Just we prove now. AB equal to BX, or B is a point lying on the perpendicular bisector of AX. So B is equidistant from A and X. So no doubt AB and BX are equal. Now if AB and BX, see, this is AB, this is BX. If AB and BX are equal, no doubt angle BAX will be equal to angle AXB. Because in a triangle, we know if two sides are equal, their opposite angles are also equal. So in place of angle, what? In place of angle BAX, we can write AXB. That means it is angle AXB plus angle AXB. So, which is equal to 2 into angle AXB. See, 2 into angle AXB. And what is the measure of AXB? Look at. It is 22 half. That means, it is 2 into 22 half degree. That is, how many degree? 45 degree. See. So, what did we prove ultimately? Ultimately, we proved or justified that angle ABC is 45 degree. And it is, in the question it was given, angle ABC 45 degree. But we have taken half of angle ABC at the vertex A. So if half of angle ABC is constructed at vertex X, then this angle is automatically becoming how many degree? 45 degree. That means it is double this angle. Okay. And in a similar manner, you can prove, considering same triangle, you see, if you consider triangle ACY, this is exterior and these two are this one and this one are interior opposite. So definitely this angle, angle ACD will be equal to angle AYC plus angle CAY. You can proceed in a similar manner to prove that this angle will be double this angle. That means angle ACD similarly, you see, similarly it can be proved that angle ACD, you see, similarly it can be proved that angle ACD will be double angle AYC, 2 into angle AYC, that is 2 into 30 degree. What is the measure of 30 degree? What is the measure of angle AYC? 30 degree we had constructed half of angle C at the vertex Y. So angle AYC is no doubt how many degree? Angle AYC is no doubt 30 degree. So 2 into 30 means it is 60 degree. You see, thus we proved that angle C will be 60 degree, angle B will be how many degree? 45 degree, and AB plus BC plus AC equal to XY, that is 14 centimeter. Okay. Thus, it is justified. Okay. Thus, the construction is justified. Then you write the steps. How did you construct the triangle? It is over. So children, I hope you understood how to construct a triangle if its perimeter is given and two base angles are given. So with this, we completed all the three constructions. Already construction one, where any side has the base, one base angle and sum of other two sides given how to construct the triangle. It was discussed in construction one. In construction two, we discussed if base is given, means if any one side of a triangle has base is given and one base angle is given and the difference of other two sides is given how to construct the triangle. It was discussed in construction two, and this is the last construction. What we discussed, how to construct a triangle if its perimeter and two base angles are given. So children, out of these three constructions, you are definitely going to get one in the exam. Okay? One question from these three constructions will certainly come. And I am sure you must have understood the steps how to construct a triangle in three different cases I discussed. Okay? What are the steps, how to justify it, everything I discussed in detail. And I am sure you must have understood. Okay, with this, the construction is over, and in fact, the total course, I mean the whole syllabus, I mean all the chapters of class 9 as per NCERT syllabus is over. I have discussed everything, okay? So children, you can see all the videos to understand. The theory part of all chapters has been discussed in detail by me. You can see for understanding all the videos one by one so that you will understand the concept. Because if you do not understand the theory, you cannot do problem, okay? For doing problem, one has to understand the theory, okay? So I hope you must have understood whatever I discussed today, the last construction. With this, the syllabus of class 9 is over. Now in the upcoming videos, upcoming classes, I shall discuss only problems from different books, which are very, very important from the examination point of view. Children, if you think, yes, what Manti sir is explaining very nicely, then I must say, children, you please hit the like button and subscribe my channel, okay? So we shall again meet in the next class with discussion of only problems, because the theory part, whatever all the chapters have been discussed in detail serially, okay? You can see, to understand the concept, whatever content is there in each and every chapter, you can go through the videos, then only we will be able to understand everything, okay? So we will again meet in the next class. Thank you.